Good morning, students.
Circuit symbol for the capacitor.
You have taken two parallel lines, and then two other lines in the middle. You take only this line and that line. These lines should be equal. That is couple of space. Don't take your too big, no, not too small. Little comfortable separation. You have taken two parallel lines. That indicates a capacitor symbol. But the capacitor symbol in circuits are different types of there. If this is for one more question, if they ask for one more question, that diagram only, this only you can do, it's only one diagram. And other diagrams are there, other symbols. If you take one line across with arrow mark, that indicates a variable capacity. Arrow is there, means it's variable, fixed not fixed. Means value of the capacitance can be changed. This is called as a variable. Capacitor. Variable capacitor, value of the C can be changed. C means capacitance. Next is electrolytic capacitor. Plus minus is called as electrolytic DC capacitor. Means only direct current. Direct current means on battery cells. If you are using, you are using this capacitor. Capacitor has an ultimate difference. The users will use this again at the end of the topic. But the capacitors basically used to store the electrical charges or electrical energy. And what is the net charge stored in them? And this is extra point related to this capacitor point. Putting the capacitor connected to the battery. The symbol for the battery and the capacitor, you have to be careful. This is C, means capacitor. Whereas the battery terminals will take one bigger line, one smaller line. This is a simple circuit of the capacitor connected to the battery. So battery constitutes V. For battery, two lines must be parallel. But compared to the capacitor, the separation of lines is lesser. And lines don't have the equal length. One is a bigger length line, that is a positive terminal. Smaller length line is negative. This means lower potential is higher potential. So voltage is 1.5 volts V, so you take that as with respect to 0, this is plus 1.75, this is the minus 0.75. Potential difference becomes equal to 0.75 plus 0.75, 1.5 volts in the current. When you connect it to the across the capacitor, then what is the function of this battery? Battery cell is a battery cell. Simply cell or circuit board. Cell means one piece. If you take the battery, means multiple cells connected in series called the battery cell. So, what is the function of the battery cell? It is provide the potential difference between the two terminals. One is a positive terminal, another one is negative terminal. So, electric charges will travel always from high potential to low potential. They try to move always from high potential to low potential. So, electrons travel in the opposite direction. So, what happens here is when you connect this battery across the capacitor, battery function is transferring of the charges. It don't provide the charges. Battery cell don't provide its own charges. It only makes the charges to pass through it. By providing the potential difference, electrons will be passed. But passing of the current always required a closed circuit. Current itself is a flow of electrons. Current means flow of electrons. Flow is required means compulsory closed circuit is required. Closed path is required. It should come back like this. But here, capacitor plates, two plates are separated by dielectric. How do you make the capacitor? Capacitor is made by taking the two conductors, separated by some dielectric and insulator. That means because the linear insulator is there, maybe sometimes drawn the diagram like this. Capacitor diagram drawn like this means this indicates a dielectric constant. This can be between the two plates. This is also drawing of the diagram of the capacitor. But generally, we don't take one circuit symbol. We take the problems proposal. If you put it like this, means you inserted the dielectric with the two parallel plates. Means of K. If it's not K, it means air dielectric, we imagine generally. Air is there inside this. But the circuit symbols we take like this only with the capacitor is there. And this electric and this one. If variable as there is, so we use this. Here, it makes the charges to travel. So, the terminal, the plate, this is a plate connected to the negative terminal of the battery, will get the negative charges. And the terminal which is having the negative or positive of the battery will get the positive charges. Equal amperage. Compulsory equal amperage. So here, plus plate connect to the positive terminal, get the positive charges, and negative terminal, plate connect to the negative terminal, get the negative charges. Equal amperage charge. What is net charge? Charge we are not creating, it just transferred. So net charge is how much? Net charges are the two plates is nothing but equal to plus Q, minus Q equal to 0. So if the charge here is plus Q, here charge is minus Q. And surface charge density, area equal area rotate. If unequal area is not taken from the capacitor plates, then you have to consider the smaller plate area effect only. These plates charges are not stored. Charges are not stored in the extra plate. Charges are stored in the opposite plate. How many charges are there? If charge is negative here, one positive charge. One negative, one positive. One negative, one positive. Outside here, there is no attraction for it. So no charges are stored. Charges required storing means compulsorily opposite plate should be there with the charges, unlike charges. Then only here are unlike charges are stored in the first plate also. But other side plates, where the opposite plate is not there, this portion, charges are not stored. Okay. And in this case, the net charge means what happens is total charge. Net charge of the capacity is different, net charge of the plates is different. You have to get to this question. Net charge of the capacity is Q, we have to say. What is the charge stored on the capacity is Q. What is the difference is V. Capacity is C. What is the relation between CVQ is? C is equals to Q by V. What is the charge of the capacity means Q, we have to say. But what is the net charge of the capacity plates if they say? Net charge means only the addition of the charges. Plus Q minus Q equal to 0. We are not creating charge, just transfer from one plate to another plate. So what is the function of this battery? Battery is doing the work to transfer the charges from one plate to other work. So it expends the energy. To transfer the charges, it has to use some energy. Some energy is needed by the battery to transfer the charges from one plate. Okay? And whatever the voltage of this battery, same amount of difference is stored on this capacitor. And charges are not stored on outer surfaces. Charges are stored on the inner surfaces because of the attraction by the unlike charges. Charges will never rest outside the plate, there is only between the plates. And here plus Q, here minus Q. Capacitance C, this is plus sigma we can take. Or plus Q, this is minus Q. Plus sigma minus sigma are given here. And potential difference across the two plates, the same battery potential difference will take this. So now, what is the definition of potential difference across the capacitors? Delta V, they will take potential difference, or D will be taken. Here, but in this topic, we talk about the symbol, potential difference V symbol will be. What is the difference? Delta V is equal to, we take V on exactly. What is the difference? We not potential. Potential means single point with respect to infinity. And potential difference means with the two points with the electric field. So between these two plates, what kind of field is present is electric field is present. That two uniform field is present. Two parallel plates are connected surface, uniform electric field is there. Except at the edges, we already discussed this uniform field and non-uniform field points. That time we got the term the capacitor. So parallel capacitor, two plates are parallel to each other is called the parallel capacitor. And any capacitor, you take the electric field is present here, but if you take the parallel plate, so electric field is uniform from plus to minus. So electric field is here from plus to minus. Separation of the plates, P say V. And potential difference is V. Then electric field and potential difference relation is E equal to V by D. Okay. And capacitor C is equal to Q by D. This point is we are taking the same thing separately. We are taking the capacitor, extra points under that. Capacitor of capacitance C, capacitor of capacitance C is connected to the bed of potential difference V. Battery or to the potential difference E. Then plate connected to plus positive terminal of battery gets a positive charge. And these points you will not be asked of this. You will not be asked of separate about this lecture I am giving you. These points will not be asked in the examination. These points are required for the other application purpose. These are the concept points related to the capacitor, how it works and connect to the battery. And the points are important, but you will not be asked of it as it is. Plate connect the positive to get the of the battery gets positive charge. And the plates create connect to negative terminal of battery gets a negative charge. And what does this battery do is battery cell provides potential difference between the two terminals. Between its two terminals. And what is the potential difference across the capacitor means? Even if you disconnect the battery also, once you connect it and remove the battery, what is the potential difference across the capacitor is V only. So charge stored on the capacitor is equal and unlike terminals. Like charges are stored on inner side of the plates, inner side of connectors or connector plates, connectors of capacitor. Equal and unlike means plus or minus, you can say plus or minus two charges are stored. If A is surface area of the plates, of connectors, then sigma plus or minus sigma is nothing but equal to 2. Or sigma is equal to plus or minus q by A. Even if battery is disconnected. Even if battery is disconnected, means removed. Then what is the charge stored? And what is the battery actually doing is transfer the electrons from positive plate to negative plate. After reaching some specific value or the maximum charge Q, then the flow of the charge starts. Initially only then the charge starts flowing. Okay. When I make the switch, for example, I make the switch here. When I close the switcher, the charge starts flowing from plus plate to minus plate. After reaching to the maximum value of the charges on the plates, then flow of the charge starts. What is the maximum value? Greater than C equal to Q by W ratio only times. And in this case, the electrons are flowing from plus to minus plate. When close the switch is closed. So in case you take the ammeter. Ammeter is a device which measures the current. If I take the ammeter, it measures the current flowing is or not. If there is no flow, reading will be zero. If the flow is there, it shows the reflection. Okay. And in this case, if you connect the ammeter anywhere in the series, when you close the switch, then you will see the reading in the ammeter. Why? Because no charges are present. But once the fully charges on the plates takes place, no more charges are transferred. In that case, the ammeter shows a zero reading. When you close the switch, instantly only you will see the reflection and then come to the current will not be flowing continuously. Why? Because it's not a closed circuit. In between the plates, what is present is dielectric is present of constant equal to. What is the function of the battery? Battery cell transfers the charges, transfer electrons from positive plates to negative plates of capacitor. From positive plate to negative plate of the capacitor. And in the maximum charge change. Maximum charge is reached on capacitor. What is the maximum charge? Q equal to C V. C is equal to Q by V. What is the capacitor? C is equal to Q by V is a relation between the C Q V. So maximum charge of the capacitor is Q equal to C V. C is the capacitance already mentioned to me, and V is the potential difference. So maximum charge that can be stored is depending on the capacitance. Capacitance is not depending on this capacitance does not depend on the charging potential base. If you give the positive charge, more positive, more voltage increases, but not a effect in the capacitance. For the given design of the capacitor plates, depending on the dielectric constant K and depending on the separation of the plates, the capacitance is already fixed. For given design capacitance, capacitance cannot be changed. It is complete. It is just fixed. For capacitor with parallel plates, a capacitor with parallel plates of separation D. We're taking the parallel plates, it's called the parallel plate capacitor of separation D. Capacitor can be of any shape, but generally we use this parallel plate capacitor, we're going to discuss mostly. For capacitor with parallel plates of separation D, electric fields E is equal to V by D is the relation. But the electric field and potential time of separation of the plates, E equal to V by D. Electric field is uniform between the plates. Is uniform between the plates. Only for the parallel capacitor purposes. Plates are parallel to each other. It's called parallel capacitor. The electric field is uniform between the plates. And the edges electric field is not uniform. That is called the fringe effect. At the edges, electric fields is non-uniform. Plus, but here is uniform at the tips, its edges, electric is non uniform. This is called the fringe effect. Fringes. There are just curved lines in there. In the field only you have the uniform. What are these lines indicate or other lines indicates is connecting wires. These are the plates you have taken. They are connecting to the plates to battery terminal. So we require wires. So these are part of the connecting wires. So take it for the plates. So plate is like this, connection is like this. And charges. Net charges less minus 0 equal to 0. And charge is just only on the inner surfaces. Charges rests only on inner surfaces of capacitor plates. Charge on the capacitor means Q effect. Q is charge on capacitor. That is Q equal to C is the relationship. And but net charge if you say charges on plates is plus or minus Q. Therefore, net charge or total charge on capacitor plates is Q net or Q total is equal to Q plus 2 minus 2 equal to 0. No trouble. Before and after connecting, charge is no trouble. The capacitor simply transferred from one plate to another plate.
So this parametric capacity is used to produce a uniform energy. Whenever you require uniform energy, there is a conductor, you can develop a parametric capacity.
This is a capacitor used in the electric motors. Using AC current motors, we use these capacitors. It contains the dielectric material, two plates. Aluminum sheets are taken, long ones thin, and between the two aluminum sheets, paper is soaked in the something called dielectric, is kept in between the two plates. So it is nothing but called as a paper capacitor also sometimes, but just electrolytic capacitor. Its value is written on it, and maximum voltage will withstand also written. The maximum voltage we will discuss about at that point later. How much voltage capacitor can withstand, that maximum voltage. If there exceeds the maximum voltage, what happens is the battery voltage exceeds the limiter, the charges C equal to Q by V fixed for that capacitance charges. If it exceeds the charges, what happens is electric field increases. Whenever the electric field increases, charges will jump from minus 2 plus 2 this gap to the electric, directly. So this is directly, there is no perfect insulator directly. So even in the plastic, glass, everything becomes conductor at high electric fields. Whenever the electric field is stronger, large enough for some kilovolts like that, if you have taken, then electrons passes through the dielectric, air, vacuum, plastic, glass, everything is a conductor only at high electric fields, a large voltage field. Electric depends on what, of course, depends. More voltage, more electric field. More electric field, more attraction to plus and minus. Electrons are moving here. Electrons express more force F equal to QE and then jump through the dielectric and the electric exits. That is called electric strength, max electric field. Dielectric instant is called as a dielectric strength. This plastic you are using as an insulator. But this for the ordinary voltage is 230 volts. But if you are using high voltage, 1000 volts, current passes through the plastic, you get the shock through this plastic also, because plastic is not a good current at high voltages. It also starts connecting. Now, this capacitor, if you are connecting, one is a there is no plus minus for this AC current circuit capacitors. Okay, any can be plus, any can be minus. There is no something like that. And it is for 440 volts, 12.5 microfarads. But we are using 230 volts AC. And if you connect this, that means you can extend up to 440. Crossing 440, little bit of okay, but because the tension already whatever mentioned, no, it is less than the actual maximum it can withstand. If it is able to withstand up to 600 volts, there will be 400 volts only. Because by mistake, if it exceeds also, it will be safe. But exceeding beyond that is the value, maximum value, then it electric breakdown takes place. The electron jump and it breaks down, it explodes, but not really bomb up, just ordinary explosion. But harmful, maybe sometimes. Charges are stored on this, so the same voltage of 230 volts. If I think 230 volts are disconnected, but charges are stored in that electric field is there, electric energy stored up, and if I touch these two, electrons jump from minus to plus, discharging takes place for discharge. All 100% charges don't go out to the discharger, maximum will go out. But every time, some little amount of charges will be there sometimes. So all charges will not go at the first touch only. Whenever they are jumping, just before touching the small gap, they jump. When they are jumping, loss of energy takes place, the loss of energy converted into heat, light, and sound. We call that as a spark. And if you have a current disconnected from the different actually, the charges will go from this plate inside to the earth. The earth takes the positive energy charges, and the charges possibly you may get the electrical shock. So by sitting on the plastic, etc., insulated from the ground, if you touch one wire, no problem. If you touch two wires, the discharge takes place through your body, you may get the electrical shock. Okay, you should not touch both the terminals. And if you remove disconnect, after current again disconnected, also charges are stored again for longer time. Charges may be lost. Sometimes the charges are less, so how they lost is the L molecules come and touch and take the charges away. So discharge takes place surrounding here, but it is a little slow process.
Next is parallel plates capacitor. Parallel plate capacitor. What do you mean parallel plates is? Two metal plates, means conductor plates. Two metal plates. Any metal
circuit.
Taken parallel to each other, kept parallel to each other, it's an electric separation. Metal plates. Kept parallel to each other. To each other. Separated by dielectric. It can be air also formed parallel capacitor. This simple thing just take two metal plates parallel to each other. Okay. Capacitance is C and they connect to the battery. What is present in these two metal plates is directly of constant A. C is the capacitance and metal plates. When you connect to the battery, what happens is power charge stored and power charge plate. Need charge stored and A. This is the capacitor. This is the unmetal capacitor. These two are the horizontal lines you are making. From here, we can connect the wire to the battery terminals. So if you connect the battery terminals, what is present here is A is present. So directly constant A is approximately equal to 1 weekend. We can keep a plastic here. We can keep a glass here. And less is separation, more attraction to the plus and minus, more capacitance will be there. Charges are not stored here. Charges are stored only at the inner surfaces. One side is plus means, other side negative. Less is the distance, more attraction and more capacitance. But you should not decrease the distance beyond the limit. Electrons will jump directly through this dielectric. So discharge takes place. Should not happen that. Okay, areas here are identical, the two plates of the same areas. Okay. And we have the derivation for this capacitance. Expression for the capacitance, for the Talbot capacitance for Feynman's function. Okay, what is C is the capacitance and K is dielectric constant. Constant is dielectric PQ. PQ, A, B, A, B, comma B. Parallel. Metal plates. This dielectric constant, sometimes you may draw the diagram even like this. Constant K. But generally we take the thickness in very very small millimeter size thickness only, we take for this diagram and for bigger things. Separation rates will be. It's